The war of 60% and TKL form factor keyboards is as old as Mahabharata, when the warriors of that time used to throw these tiny keycaps on each other, and of course the TKL ones always won. And that was a lame intro joke this time. Hey everyone, Mukul here. Mukul's hands here. Hi. That was confusing. The MK1200 Mini is a 60% keyboard and hence the word mini attached to it. The MK1000 is a TKL keyboard and hence no search word as mini is written next to it. Well, throughout the video, I will refer to the MK1200 Mini as MK1200. So don't go bashing me in the comments if in future they launch a MK1200 too. And if you're from the future, let me know. Well, these two keyboards are priced quite closely to each other, and except for the apparent difference of their form factor and the total number of keys, which is 61 on the MK1200 and 87 on the MK1000, well, let me share what else is different between these two. The overall length of the MK1200 is about 11.5 inches and MK1000 is about 14 inches. And if you don't like inches, convert that into centimeters or millimeters or meters, I don't care. So if you have a really congested space which can't afford the difference in length here, the MK1200 Mini will be a good choice. But the 60% form factor has some drawbacks which I have shared in my main review video. You can go check it out so that I don't waste your time again with the same info. Now, because the MK1200 Mini is smaller, it's lighter and hence easier to carry if you like carrying keyboards around. Both of these keyboards are mostly plastic except for the part where the MK1000 has a metal plate under its keys. Yeah, that's the metal plate. And the other huge difference is that the MK1000 has extendable feet whereas the MK1200 doesn't, which might not work for those who always use them on their keyboards. The USB wire on both of these keyboards is braided, but the MK1200 one is removable and hence it would have less issues if you ever want to pack it in a tight bag. But why would you ever want to do that? Let me know, as I am totally clueless. The wire of the MK1000 is towards the right and MK1200 one plugs right at the center of it. And did I mention the MK1200 Mini uses a USB-C cable? Both of these keyboards have cherry style stem keycaps which are ABS double shot, but the imprints of the MK1000 are really dull. And as you can see, the MK1200 Mini key doesn't have this extremely translucent layer of ABS under it. So this is the reason why the lights of the MK1200 won't be as bright as the MK1000, despite the fact that both of these keyboards have LEDs right on top of them throughout the keyboard layout. And because of that fact, you can notice that the imprints on the MK1000 are extremely faded as compared to the imprints on the keys of the MK1200. And because of that, if you ever plan to use these keyboards without the backlights turned on, then you would have a hard time reading the font and the texts on the MK1000 as compared to the MK1200. Now, because the MK1200 has that advantage, the disadvantage which it has is that the overall backlight brightness of it is really low as compared to the MK1000. So yeah, weigh your options. Now, some of you might just like the idea of having not too bright keys on the MK1200, but you can decrease the intensity of these lights on the MK1000. Well, personally, I would prefer having the option of having brighter keys on my keyboard than not having that flexibility. Not sure about you though. But because they are super bright, they are quite reflective on the neighboring keys too. Some might like it and some might not. Subjective thingies on objective keyboards. And one more little problem with the MK1200 Mini is that these icons won't light up if you are working in a dark room and you are expecting the backlight to work for these icons too, which are kinda necessary for some shortcuts. But no such issue will be there with the MK1000 except for the multimedia keys, which aren't as important. And both of them have about the same amount of roughness on their keycaps too. The font on both of these is the same, but as you can notice, there is a gap between the function keys and the numerical keys on the MK1000. The switches on the MK1000 are Oitemu blues, whereas on the MK1200, they are some YH branded blue switches. To be honest, in terms of usage and the general design difference between these two keyboards, the overall feel of the switches are more or less the same, with just a slight difference that the MK1000 keys might just need a little less actuation force for them, so it might just be slightly better for gaming. But the difference is so little that most of you won't be able to notice it. And here's a sound comparison between these two, which I took earlier. Clearly, the MK1000 key sounds slightly more rattly and noisy as compared to the MK1200. To put this in simpler terms, the MK1200 mini has more bass and the MK1000 has more treble. Yeah, that's it. Also, the spacebar sounds more stable on the MK1200. So when it comes to the general usage, the MK1000 is better when it comes to typing a lot or editing what you typed a lot. Of course, you can do that too on the MK1200, but few tasks might require you to entertain certain shortcuts to activate or deactivate a few keys. Like the most crucial ones are these arrow keys. I mean, if you want to jump right or left as you draft an email or that novel which you have been trying to finish for 10 years now, the TKL form factor of the MK1000 will favor you more. But if you're someone who uses the calculator application a lot, then my friend, you're watching the wrong video. I'm pretty sure you must have noticed the topmost row of the MK1200 mini has both the numerical keys and the function keys on them. So for example, to Alt F4 something, you would need to hold the extra Fn key. But there are these few tiny restrictions on a 60% form factor keyboard such as the MK1200 mini here. For example, if you have these arrow keys turned on, you can't use the right Alt key as the Alt key. And to close a program or a window, you would need to hold the left Alt key and the function key and F4. For some, this might not be a hassle, but for me, it definitely is. However, on the MK1000, something like this won't be an issue, and also there are these multimedia control shortcuts on the function keys, which you can activate by holding the Fn key and the corresponding icon key. I will post the different set of shortcuts and keyboard functions on your screen, because really the video is not a brochure of these keyboards and most of these shortcuts should be self-explanatory. When it comes to the different RGB presets, the MK1000 has about 10 of them and the MK1200 has 17 of them. I've tried to show them in a previous video. Both of these keyboards don't come with any sort of software support, and hence you can't really set individual light keys colors on them. And both of them do come with 1 year of warranty, which is quite fine for their price, which is about 2100 rupees approximately. So I hope by the many listed differences here, you would be pretty clear by now which keyboard you are gonna choose. But if you're still a bit confused, let me share a quick summary. If your usage doesn't require a lot of typing and the form factor is your priority, then you can definitely choose the MK1200 mini. But if you're someone who types a lot and edits a lot of stuff, then having these extra keys on the MK1000 really helps a lot. So if this video helped you choose one, you can buy from my affiliate links in the description below. And here's hoping that looking mostly at my two hands didn't bore you today, as I only have two hands. Stay safe, humans. That's all for today. MewBot out.